So, large application practicum basically means a course which teaches you tools and techniques to handle large projects which have several lines of codes or several files. And then over this course, you will learn a number of tools and techniques which help you manage large applications. The first utility which we will be learning today is the make utility, which allows us to compile a program which has several files or several lines of code. So let's get started with the make utility and see how it works. The first thing, a make utility, which is a utility available in Linux or Unix-like operating systems, is that it looks for a file which is called a make file. So make file basically is a simple way to organize code compilation. So basically what make allows you to write certain rules in make files, which when make is called on the command prompt, reads the make file, runs those rules from top to bottom, and enables the compilation or linking of the program. So as it says that make program aids you in developing your large programs by keeping track of which portions of the code have changed, compiling only those parts of the program which have, say, changed since its last compilation. So because make is intelligent, it keeps track of what files have changed since the last compile or last call to make. Make actually simplifies compilation by reducing the time as well as the resources needed to compile programs by only compiling those files, recompiling those files which have changed. So assume that you have a project in which you have the following files like main.cpp, function.h, eat.cpp, code.cpp, sleep.cpp. Cpp is an extension which is for a C++ file. And eats, codes, and sleep contains definition of the corresponding functions in this file. So let's take an example. Suppose the main.cpp looks on the the panel on the left. As you can see, it has an iostream.h file, which is the input-output file utility. And then it has functions.h header file included. So these are the include statements, which include the ability to input and output, as well as the definition of the functions, the declarations of the functions. Within the main program, there is a cout statement which prints my routine, and then eat, code, and sleep is called one by one, and it is returning 0 because it has a return type int. And in the functions.h, we have the function declarations for eat, code, and sleep. Eat is in rupees, how much money you spend in eating, maybe how many lines of code you write, and how many hours of sleep you get. So if we had to compile these files into an executable file, which is called routine, we will have to run a command like G++ minus O output routine, the name of the executable, and then the name of the files, which are the CPP files in the folder or in the directory, which need to be compiled. But as you can see, if you had a few files, this is fine. But if you had multiple such files, it becomes a very laborious process where you may even skip some files and or forget to include such files, and the G++ command will not work properly. So the answer to this long compile is to use the make utility, where you will just run make on the command prompt rather than the G++ statement. The make utility will look for a file called the make file in the folder, which will contain statements like these, which get compiled. So, first question is, how do we write a make file, which is a file which the make utility looks for? So, make file tells make how to compile, link a program, what are the steps to be executed. And generally, a make file consists of a set of rules which are executed in a top-down manner. A rule generally consists of a target, which could be an executable file which needs to be created, the set of prerequisites of the CPP files which need to be included, and recipes, which are tapped statements which go from the prerequisite to get at the target, like G++. So this kind of structure is there in a make file, and a number of rules are written which have these structures. So generally a target usually is the name of the file that generated by a program, typically an executable file. Okay. Like for example, the target could be routine. Prerequisites are the things which are used as inputs to create the target. And the target often depends upon several files, which are the prerequisites. In our example, they are the CPP files. Then the recipe is the action that the make has to carry out in order to go from the prerequisites to actually get to the target. So in this case, the recipe could be the G++ statement, which we have written on the command prompt, which is written inside as a recipe inside a rule in the make file. And remember that every recipe statement has to be tabbed and there is a tab before the recipe statement for the make utility to recognize it as a new recipe statement. So for example, a recipe in a make file could consist of routine space colon space and the key.cpp space code.cpp dot space sleep.cpp, and then there is a tab and then the G++ statement. So what this will do, if you write make, it will go and find this rule. It will see these are the prerequisites. This statement is executed and a routine will be created in the folder. But the problem with this is, yes, it is efficient. You need to only write it once and then keep calling make. But the problem is that this particular statement is called every time make is run. In the next part of this make utility series, we are going to also look how to make a make command more usable for where we only need to compile things which have changed since its last compile. So these are the resources I have used to create this lecture, which include the GNU make page as well as the Kolbe edu page. And I acknowledge some of the TAs who have helped in creating these slides. This leads us to the activity in this lecture. And the activity basically consists of trying out what I just taught you, first compiling a C++ program without the make utility, and then compiling the C++ program with the make utility, and doing this in a systematic manner. So there is already an activity folder which has been given to you along with this lecture, and this is the activity folder. As you can see, inside this activity folder, we have some cpp.h files. And these basically are a program which basically calculates a factorial and says hello before reporting the factorial value. So for example, it can calculate 5 factorial for you, which is 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. But before doing the factorial, it will also say hello to you. So although we already have an activity, you can create an example folder where you can put all these files and then you can write the G++ command to run it. So as you can see, I'm using a Windows computer, and on Windows, I do not have Linux or Unix. So one way of emulating Linux or Unix on Windows is to go onto the Microsoft Store. Go into the search. You can either search for store and you will get to Microsoft Store, or generally you will also find a shortcut to the Microsoft Store right here. You open this store and you actually, once it gets loaded, you can search for Ubuntu. And when you search for Ubuntu, you will get a number of installation versions. And you can choose the latest one, which is 24.0.1 LTS. And once you do it, you will actually get an install button here, which is for me open because I've already installed it. But you need to install it and then open it. So once you have installed it, you can open it by writing Ubuntu and clicking, will open a command prompt, and the command prompt will look like this. Now this is a dollar prompt and this is actually a Linux prompt. So I can just tell you where I am, and if you see, I am in my home Varun activity one folder. And you might say, where is this path, where is this folder located? So to find this out, you can run explorer .exe with the current file, and it will open basically the path to where this folder is located. And you can see that there is actually some kind of virtualization has happened where this Ubuntu is running, and then this is basically the path to my and to my folder where I have already kept the activity, and you can see all the files which were there in the activity, including there is a make file. So before we go and run the make file, you may want to compile this program using the G++ statement, and a typical G++ statement would look like this, where we can write G++ minus O hello, and then you will write all the name of the files, and when you run this statement, the program will get compiled. In contrast, you can also create a make file, and for that, you can actually touch a make file, which will create an empty make file. You can actually touch a make file, and when you do that and you ls, you will actually see that a make file gets created, and this is the make file right here, and I can also open it for you, and I can show it to you how it looks like, and this is how it looks like. For me, a make file will be empty, and this is what you need to write. You need to write hello colon space space main hello function h, and then tab, and then the G++ statement. So now if you have written this and you go back to your command prompt and now you write make, you will actually say you can actually run it. And here it says that there is already a hello created before by running make. So there is hello is up to date. Make did not need to compile anything right now. So this hello, which is glowing in green, is the executable file and which has been created by running the make. And if I just execute it by writing got / hello, you see it will say hello world, the factorial of 5 is 120. So this is the output of the prompt. So if you want, I can also remove the hello file. And now let me run the ls, and the hello has disappeared. And I can do make, and you can actually see it has actually run this command, the recipe statement. And if I do long listing, you can see now the hello has got created, which is a result of running the make. When I run the make, it looks for the make file, it compiles, it runs the rule in the make file, which is the rule I showed you here, this rule, which is basically the compile state. Okay, so this is basically what you need to do in this activity. I would request you all to actually try this activity out. First, if you're running a Windows machine, install Linux, and then open Linux, Ubuntu 24.04.1 LTS, and then in case you get an error, you may need to install make, and for installing make, you may need to run the apt get command, and just to show you how the apt get command runs. So in my case, I did not have G++ as well, so I had to do sudo, which is basically giving access to superuser, which may require you to use a password. When you run Ubuntu for the first time or every time, it will ask you to set a username, which in my case is Varun, and a password. But the same password will have to be given when you write sudo apt install G++, and it will install G++. And before you run G++, it may be wise to run an update of apt and an upgrade of all the packages before you run the G++. Also, if you want to install make, you can also do sudo apt install make, and this will install the make utility code. So I hope this was a learning experience for you. Please try it out, and we will meet in the next lecture where I will show you other utility of using make command. Thank you.